In 2004, the Olympic Games returned to their ancient birthplace and the city of their revival, with athletes from over 200 nations uniting in Greece to engage in spirited competition. Celebration, heritage, participation, and human scale united to form the theme of the Athens 2004 Olympic Games. And these noble goals were well represented in 2004 on the site of the first modern Olympic Games, the Panathinaikos Stadium, as the Olympic archery competition took place on a site of significant Olympic history, dating back over 2,300 years. As evidence, consider that at the 2003 World Championships in New York City, more than 488 archers from 67 nations competed, and for the first time the four individual titles were won by archers from four different continents. Another example of this emergence of talent worldwide is the fact that India, which enjoyed an outstanding 2003 World Championships, qualified the full quota of three men and women for Athens competition, a level of participation on a par with established archery powers like Korea and Ukraine. Entering Athens, the sport of archery was hoping to maintain one of the Olympic Games' most interesting streaks, that being the fact that the host nations of the past six games, dating back to Moscow 1980, have won at least one archery gold medal. In Athens, the Greek hopes were well placed in their excellent women's competitor, Evangelia Passara. Greece's faith in Passara was justified insofar as archery has reached a level of global parity unsurpassed in its history. Despite the new and improved level of competition, the Korean women's team continues to lead the archery world in success with an Olympic gold medal in every event they have ever contested since their first participation in 1984 in Los Angeles. The record stood at 9 gold medals and counting, as the Korean women, led by 2001 world champion Park Sung-hyun, swept the gold medals in Sydney. The Korean men's team came into Athens as defending Olympic and world team champions, and, remarkably, in pursuit of their first individual Olympic gold medal. In addition to Korea's Park, defending men's individual champion from Sydney, Simon Fairweather of Australia, countryman David Barnes, who won bronze at the 2003 Worlds, and Italy's Michele Frangilli were also poised to challenge for the medal stand in Athens. In the case of Park and Fairweather, it should be noted that no archer has ever successfully defended an Olympic individual title in consecutive Olympic Games. Women's ranking began at the Dhekelia Air Force Base at 9 a.m. on Tuesday, the 12th of August, with the Koreans expected to place well based on their recent performances and their incumbency as defending Olympic champions in individual and the team medal categories. The 2001 world champion and Sydney silver medalist Park Sung-hyun showed herself to be a leading Athens medal prospect with a world record score of 682, including 38 10-point arrows, with 16 in the inner circle. Teammate Lee Sung-yin qualified second at 675, featuring 34 in the yellow. And the third Korean competitor and defending Olympic champion, Yun Mi-yin, posted a 673 score in giving the Koreans a sweep of the first three ranking positions. Following in fourth place was He Ying of China at 667 and 13 inner tens, a number second only to top qualifier Park of Korea. He Ying's teammate Zhang Yuan Yuan pressed her teammate in the ranking round, but finished a close fifth with a score of 663. Finishing in sixth place was Yuan Shu Qi of Chinese Taipei at 658 points. With Park, Lee and Yun in their respective top three places, the medal prospects for the Korean women looked promising, and the rest of the field was all too well aware of their potential domination of the competition. The men's ranking later in the day reflected the fact that the medal prospects could come from any number of countries with competitors participating in Athens. But the Korean dominance factor continued at the top of the table with Im Dong-hyun, the Olympic test event winner and silver medalist in the 2003 World Outdoor Championships, taking honours with a world record score of 687 points. Runner-up Magnus Peterson of Sweden had 41 10-pointers, including 16 inner tens on his way to a 673 score. Michele Frangilli finished a disappointing 24th in the ranking round, but could not be counted out of the medal consideration based on a stellar career and extensive international experience. The Koreans continued to secure ranking positions in the top five, with Park Kyung-mo scoring 672 to secure the fourth position, and Yang Yong-ho 1 point behind his teammate in fifth with a score of 671 points that included 18 inner tens. So, with the Korean men and women establishing themselves as eight of the top 10 seeds with two world records in the process, the rest of the world understood the road to Olympic medals required success against the dominant Olympic archery power in history.
I know this stadium has been an excellent venue for us. It's got a lot of attention for us. It's so historic. It's the best venue in Athens, and we're very proud to be here. We worked hard to make sure our competition honored the tradition of this venue, and I think we've done that. We've had terrific competitions. We saw the Korean men, who are very strong, get beaten and not get into the final four, and that was showing how strong our sport is getting to be worldwide. And I think we're looking forward to trying to have venues maybe never as good as this one, but venues that are exceptional in every city that we go to, something we can be especially proud of and that is different.
Individual medal matches began on August the 18th with the women's competition. The bronze match pitted Great Britain's 21st ranked surprise, Alison Williamson, against Yuan Shu Qi of Chinese Taipei, who had overcome Korea's third ranked and defending Sydney gold medalist, Yun Mi Yin, in the quarterfinals. Women's individual gold medal match pitted the two top seeds of the competition, Korean teammates Park Sung-hyun and Lee Sung-yin. Park had marched through the tournament averaging 20 points better than her opponents. Lee had managed a 15-point average margin of victory on her side of the draw.
bronze medal, representing Great Britain, Alison Williamson. Silver medal, representing Korea, Lee Song Jin. Gold medal and Olympic champion, representing Korea, Park Sung Hun.
Day three of the finals brought together Commonwealth competitor Tim Cudahy of Australia and Lawrence Godfrey of Great Britain in the bronze medal match. Both had heart-stopping journeys in their quarter-final and semi-final matches, with all four matches determined by 2 points or less. Number 3 ranked seed Marco Galeazzo of Italy faced Japan's Hiroshi Yamamoto in the men's individual gold medal match. Yamamoto defeated Tim Cudahy of Australia in a one-arrow shoot-off in their semi-final, while the Italian won by 2 points over the 31st ranked Brit Lawrence Godfrey in their semi-final matchup.
Go.
Tim Cudahy. Silver medal, representing Japan, Hiroshi Yamamoto. Champion, representing Italy, Marco Galeazzo.
Women's team gold medal match pitted longtime rivals Korea and China. Korea led by the top three ranked archers in the competition, and China with seeds 4, 5 and 11. The Koreans were after their fifth consecutive team gold, a string of success unmatched in the sport.
The team of Chinese Taipei, Lui Shuji, Wu Guju, and Chen Li Zhu. The team of the People's Republic of China, Huo Yi, Chen Yuan Yuan, and Lin Song. Gold medal and Olympic champions,
Yomada des Koreas,
L'équipe de la Corée,
the team of Korea, Lee Song Jin and Yun Mi Jin.
Υποδεχτείτε τους τοξότες για τον τελικό για το χρυσό μετάλλιο.
Mesdames et messieurs, merci d'accueillir les archers pour la finale olympique de l'épreuve par équipe hommes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the archers for the gold medal match.
Με σειρά κατάταξης νούμερο 1, Κορέα!
At target 1, ranked first, Korea!
Στο στόχο 2, με σειρά κατάταξης νούμερο 2, Κινέζικη Ταϊπέι!
At target 2, ranked second, Chinese Taipei!
Of the 2004 Olympic Games in the sport of archery, the gold medal match in the men's team event. And to no one's surprise, Korea is contesting the match on target number 1.
After their 1-point victory over the USA in their semi-final, the Chinese Taipei men were faced with a daunting task in the team gold medal final. Their opponents being the current world champions Korea, with 3 of the top 5 ranked archers in the competition, and their Sydney Olympic title to defend.
Yeah. Park Jong-ho and Chong Jong-ho.